5 leg view, over.
Aw, man, there's no fear.
Hey, not shut that thing.
Fear. Come on, it's taking so long.
I'm almost there.
View, over.
Residents belonging to Professor Caldwell have been unable to verify occupancy, over.
Man, will you look at this? I thought our history test was supposed to be easy.
Stop it. Let's go.
Done.
Probably not. Two up.
Whoa, boys, we got company.
Oh, man, I'm out of here.
Let's go, let's go, go!
She better not be getting in any of my CDs.
Oh. Okay, kiddo. It's an emergency. Mom, you can't afford this. Thanks.
Make us proud, Mary Catherine.
I will, Dad. Bye, Mom.
Hey, you guys drive carefully.
Always.
Foot.
Sorry about that.
Don't worry about it. Hey, you're in my economics class.
Yeah, I know. You were out the second week with strep, right?
You noticed. Yeah, what's my name? David McPherson.
Mary Stewartson.
Hey, you know, some of these guys call me Mac, but I like David.
David?
Uh-huh. Actually, I'm part of the team. I take care of the equipment. Woo!
Let's go, Stewart's. Marvelous place.
Jesse, what's going on?
You're a reporter. You figure it out.
You know, not everything has to be a competition. Sorry, I was late. My poli-sci test went over.
Yeah. Listen, Mary, I have an assignment for you if you want it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, there was a break-in last night at Professor Caldwell's house while he was at the pep rally.
Convenient. Anything taken?
Apparently not.
Any suspects?
Three. Running away from the house. Too dark to see any faces.
And nothing was taken. Doesn't sound like much.
No, probably not, but...
This is me leaving. Have you ever had anything like this happen before?
A couple of years ago, I was TP'd on Halloween, but then the whole block was.
And you're sure nothing was stolen? No jewelry, money, electronics, anything like that?
Nope.
Okay. Thanks for your time, Professor.
Sure thing.
Professor, I was just thinking. The midterms are coming up. I mean, you don't by any chance keep your test sheets here at home, do you?
Well, they're on the computer, but they need my password to get in. Perfect.
Birth dates, social security numbers, mother's maiden name. They're all the most common passwords.
Well, you were right. Somebody logged on last night.
They took the test questions?
Well, someone was definitely in that file. Oh, I guess it was time to change that test anyway, huh?
You think they were students?
Yeah, they were students.
How can you be so sure? You know who did it, don't you?
Well, I didn't see any faces, if that's what you mean.
Well, you have an idea. I mean, you must if you say they were students.
I have an idea. Look, let me put it to you this way. I used to play football, and I know the difference between getting shoved by some punk and taking a hit from an all-conference blocking back.
Are you saying they were football players that broke into Professor Caldwell's house?
I'm saying they were big and fast and strong, and I took a hit.
Thanks for your time.
You're welcome.
14:52! 14:52! Now! Set!
Huh? He was supposed to be your man. I called a reverse, remember?
Yeah, I remember.
And where the hell were you?
Where was I?
Yeah.
Right here!
Knock it off! Knock it off, you guys!
Right here!
Knock that off! Boswell.
Sorry, Coach. Guess I missed him.
You do it again, you're not starting on Saturday. You hear me? Now let's play football.
All right. Atkins formation. Pass 50K on one. Ready?
Excuse me.
All right, let's go!
Oh, this is a close practice, sweetheart.
Get off the ball!
Coach Jefferson, Mary Stewartson, from the Clarion. I was wondering if I could interview a couple of your players.
Well, why don't you talk to me first, then we'll see.
Well, I know you guys are going to be going to a bowl game if everything works out.
Damn straight.
Roberts, what are you doing? He was wide open there!
Well, I was just wondering... I mean, what would happen if one of your players was involved in something he shouldn't have been? Would he be taken out of the lineup? Because I've heard stories where athletes commit crimes and, like, let's say, possibly breaking into a professor's house, maybe stealing test questions and never being disciplined for it. Because the game's a thing, right?
Yeah, the game is the thing, miss, but let me tell you something. I would never condone any of my players committing a criminal act. Now, you asked if he'd be out of the lineup. Not only would he be out of the lineup, he'd be out in that parking lot so fast to make his eyes spin. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Carter! Hello! Where's your man? Come on, people! Think!
Yes, sir. I'm Mary Stewartson from the Clarion. I'm working on a story about the break-in and robbery at Professor Caldwell's house last night.
Robbery?
And I was under the impression nothing was stolen.
Well, it looks like Professor Caldwell's computer files were broken into. And it's possible one of his tests was taken. It's also possible members of the football team were involved.
Who told you that?
A source, actually. I would like to know what would happen if members of the football team were implicated in the robbery.
Standard operating procedures for the review and disciplinary process, adjudicating student conduct. You're welcome to look through them if you like, Miss Stewartson.
You enjoyed yourself?
Yeah. That was fun, thanks.
My pleasure. Ah, lovely evening for a walk. So you really think it was someone on the team that broke into Caldwell?
Possibility. Any ideas?
Oh, God, I don't know, you know. I mean, I like being a part of the team in some ways, but I don't really know any of the guys that well. You're using me as a source, aren't you?
Well, maybe just a little. I'm just trying to find my way into the story. I don't know, maybe it was just a couple kids fooling around, stealing test questions, but what if it was someone on the team? With the Falcons coming up in a bowl game, it could make for an interesting mix.
If it was one of the Falcons. So you always wanted to be a writer?
Yeah, when I was 8, I had this friend, Caroline, and we used to write these newsletters, give them to our neighbors.
Uh-huh. How long did you do that for?
Until Caroline wrote about Mrs. White in the corner house and her good-looking brother that would come over every night when Mr. White was at work.
And I guess that Mrs. White never had a brother, huh?
Hey, you guys!
There's Lily.
Hey, Billy.
Hey, Mary. Long time no see.
Hey.
What's going on? Hey, Mac, how you doing?
What's up, Billy?
Billy and I went to Kennedy High together.
Oh, you did?
Mm-hmm. Actually, that's how we met. I told him my roommate went to his high school, and we just started talking. So took it from there.
Mm-hmm.
So, Mac, you going to the Alpha Tau party Saturday night?
I don't know, man. It's not my...
Come on, man. It'll be a blast.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You ever been to a frat party?
Come on. It'll be fun.
Come on.
Come on. All right. Sure, why not?
Good.
Good.
Hey, why don't you guys sit down and grab a drink?
Yeah.
Not much here, is there?
That's all I've got so far. Someone broke into Caldwell's house, logged on his computer, and probably took the test questions. Yeah, I know the article's boring. But the guard implied that the guys were big enough to be football players. Maybe I can question some of the Falcons at the Alpha Tau party on Saturday.
Good luck. You know they're off limits this close to a game.
Yeah, I guess I pressed the coach too hard.
Well, burning the source. It happens.
Not to me.
Shake a leg, you know what I mean?
You having fun?
Yeah,
you
know, it's fun.
Yeah, well, you know, it is what it is, right? Hey, you know, we don't have to hang out here if you don't want to. Seriously, come on, let's get out of here. We'll go somewhere where we can actually hear each other.
Are you sure?
I'm positive. Connor, she'll be fine.
So where are we going?
Them up from the long left. Yeah, just go, Mary.
You want something to drink?
Yeah, we get me something slushy.
Something slushy?
Yeah.
Excuse me, I'm a doctor.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, I had a great time.
What's going on? Something happened at the party tonight? What happened? Please, you're scaring me.
I can't talk about this.
But Holly, you're shaking.
No, I'm just cold, that's all.
Please don't lie to me. What happened at the party? You have to tell me what happened. You have to tell me, please. Holly, I'm your friend. I care about you. Did something happen between you and Billy tonight? What did Billy do to you?
It was Clay. Clay Roberts. He raped me. I was afraid. I mean, I like Clay Roberts, but I didn't want to sleep with him. I thought that we're just gonna go up and talk, you know? When we got in the room, he told me to take off my dress. He was kidding. He started touching me. I tried to fight. I swear to God, I did. But he was so strong.
wrong. Put my hands up and I tried to scream. He put his hand over my mouth. I couldn't breathe. It was so heavy.
We have to get you to a hospital.
No, no, I'm not going to a hospital.
You have to let a doctor look at you. What if he gave you something? You know you have to let a doctor see you. You know you do. I'm so tired. I just want to go to sleep for a while. I just want to close my eyes. Then we'll go, okay?
How you doing?
I'm okay. This is Dr. Taylor.
I want you to take these only if you have trouble sleeping.
Oh, God.
Holly, the university and this center has set up some excellent resources to handle situations like these. Counseling, support groups. I'm going to send your test results to Mr. Dixon, the Dean of Student Affairs. I think it's a good idea if you see him as soon as possible. His office can handle everything for you. Now, I made an appointment for you to come back and see me next week. But if you need me for anything, even if it's just to talk, you call me here at the center, okay?
Thanks.
Well, I guess it's time to go to the cops.
I'm not going to the cops.
Why not?
You are Dr. Taylor. They've got plenty of resources here on campus that can help.
Well, yeah, but...
I'm not going to the cops.
I'm sorry, but he's gonna get away with it, Holly.
Not if I go to the Dean of Student Affairs. He'll go on his record. He'll be punished.
By maybe kicking him out of school or suspending him for a semester. I mean, what if they just put him on probation? He should be in jail.
Maybe.
What do you mean, maybe?
Things seem so different in the light of day, you know? And you saw me, I was pretty wasted, and so was Clay.
That doesn't give him the right to rape you. Holly, you said no. That should have been enough.
I know, okay, but what if I had done something different? What if I hadn't gone upstairs, or if I'd said something else, or what if he didn't hear me right? Or maybe he got the wrong idea from the way I was acting.
Tell me you're not saying you think this was your fault.
I don't think it was my fault.
That's the way she wants it, Mom. I don't know what else I can do.
If she won't go to the police, you can't force her.
No, it's just... This guy should be in jail.
Honey?
There isn't any possibility that he might try anything else, is there? I mean, you were sharing a room with Holly.
No, I'd have to be crazy to try something, especially with the hearing coming up tomorrow.
Are you gonna be there with her?
I'm not allowed in the actual hearing. No one is. Holly has to go in alone. I'll be waiting for her outside.
Mary?
Mom, I have to go. Holly's awake.
Okay, well, please tell her I'm thinking about her.
I will. Love you both.
That's going to wrap it up for now, Miss Sherman. Anything you would like to add?
No, I don't think so.
All right.
So, what's going to happen now?
Well, now, of course, you need to listen to Mr. Roberts' version of the event. And
determine what action may be necessary and appropriate. Yeah. Okay. You're going to be notified just as soon as there is a decision.
Thank you.
I do want to assure you, this university and this office in particular would never countenance the type of behavior you've just spoken of. We take these matters very, very seriously. I hope you can take advantage of some of our counseling services.
Thank you.
All right, I'll let you.
You okay?
Hey, Mr. Dixon, how are you?
Counselor, could you and your client join me inside my office?
Excuse me a second.
You specifically told Holly she had to come in alone.
It's fine.
How come he gets to have a lawyer present?
Because that is how this university's adjudication system works.
That is not fair.
The accused has a right to counsel if and when he chooses. Could you excuse us, please?
How is she?
Not so good. She's sort of pretending it never happened.
Look, if there's anything I can do, please.
I don't think so, but thanks for asking.
Is she gonna go to the police?
No. I keep asking her, but she's determined to see it through the university system. Clay Roberts gets to bring in an attorney, but Holly has to go in alone. Does that sound fair?
Holly's really lucky to have a friend like you.
Hey, wait up!
Holly? These cases are difficult at best, and the university has a responsibility to act in what it deems to be the best interest of all concerned. In this case, since there is no physical evidence that intercourse took place... No physical evidence? But what about the test you took at the center, Holly? What about... Holly...
Stop. You must hate me.
No, of course not.
You know, May, I know that if I hadn't taken that shower cleaned up the way I did, there would have been some evidence, something.
Holly, I probably would have done the same thing if I was in your situation.
I know, I could have been so stupid.
You know, I think it's time we go talk to the real cop.
Right, you know what? It's going to be the same old thing, my word against Clay Roberts. I don't want to think about it anymore. I just want to forget it. It's over.
Oh, you got the touch problem.
Help you?
Yes. I need to talk to someone about reporting a rape.
Let me see who's available.
Detective Brubaker, you wanted to talk to me about a rape?
Yes. It was my roommate at the university.
Morning. So this party, you were there?
Yes, but I left with a friend before it happened.
Were there any witnesses to the crime?
Holly said it was just Clay and her in the room.
Did she scream or call for help? Is there a chance maybe somebody heard her struggling?
I don't know. I mean, the music was really loud. Besides,
She said Clay had his hand over her mouth.
And where's your roommate now?
Probably still in bed. The doctor gave her these sleeping pills.
Okay, Mary, here's the problem the way I see it. You want to report a rape. Only the victim won't come in and give a formal statement. There's no physical evidence, and the alleged perpetrator who claims no sexual act took place has already been found innocent under the university system.
But he's walking around campus like he didn't do anything. I should have insisted she come here first. I knew she shouldn't have gone through the university.
Let me show you something. That's 21 sexual assaults at Cornwall last year.
But our campus is listed as one of the safest in the country.
Mm-hmm. That's because only two of those cases resulted in charges.
Why?
Well, it was hard enough for most of those women to report the results. Now, unfortunately, if you wait too long, the evidence we need to charge a suspect simply isn't there anymore.
It's me. Open up.
Mary?
Holly, it's me. Open the door. Holly, you know, you don't have to do that.
They were outside before you came.
Who?
Clay. Someone. Outside yelling and banging at the door. Oh, God. You don't believe me.
Yes, I do.
You heard the doctor. They're only to help me sleep sometimes.
I know.
Then why are you looking at me like that?
I don't know. I just don't...
I had one. One. And then I woke up because they were banging and they were yelling at the door and you weren't here.
I just needed to go talk to someone.
I needed you here. We promised that we were going to stick together. We promised each other.
I know. I'm sorry.
You promised me.
God, Holly, I'm so sorry.
Don't. I can't do this.
I thought you were working on the Caldwell break.
You know as well as I do. That story's dead.
So what? Ace quarterback, rape student, gets away with it?
You know I can't write that.
Then what? Think. What's your objective?
Maybe it's not just about Holly. Maybe it's about more than that.
Go on.
Well, this university, it's like its own little city. I mean, it has its own police force, courts, judges. You know, I was looking through the school disciplinary code. Did you know you're automatically expelled for drinking underage, but you rape a woman, and the punishment starts at a simple probation? That just isn't right.
What else?
Well, it keeps coming back to Holly and Clay. I found out that if the Falcons make it to a bowl game, it could bring over $1 million to the school. And with Clay as the quarterback for the Falcons, if he gets arrested...
Watch it! Set! Left! 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 Left!
And if we run that play one more time, I got that guy by
five. Hey, Billy. Clay, you got a minute for the Clarion?
Coach sees me talking to you. I'll be running laps all night long.
Then don't talk to me.
So what do you want to know?
I understand you still hold three state records back home. One for total offense, one for passing yards, and the other...
Scoring.
That's right. Scoring.
Look, I know who you are. And I also know you're not here to do some puff piece on me, so why don't you tell me what you really want?
I'm just trying to be fair, Clay. I mean, I looked into your background, and you just don't seem like a rapist to me.
That's because I'm not.
Well, then why did Holly Sherman say you raped her?
Because she wanted to have sex, and I turned her down. Guess she just got ticked, you know, decided to make me pay for hurting her feelings or something. I don't know.
You really think she'd do that? Falsely accuse you? I mean, put your education, your football career in jeopardy?
That's what she did, didn't she?
What's up, Mary? Clay?
Hey, Mac, how about a couple cold towels over here?
You all right?
We're fine, Dave.
If you need anything.
Yeah, we're fine, David. Thank you. Thanks, David. Such a sweet. Now, you want anything else?
Yeah, I have one more question. Do you think the university would let you get away with raping Holly if you weren't the star quarterback about to lead them to a bowl championship game?
You should leave now.
You sure you don't want to say anything else? I mean... What about that scoring record? I mean, how did that work? Was Holly figured in the total? I'm just trying to tell your side, Clay.
I don't need to tell you guys how important this game is. All right. Today I want to work on cleaning up the 50 series. It's up to you guys to make sure Clay's got time to throw that ball.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. Hey. Hey. You're cool, AC.
What's up? How can you stay friends with these guys?
I told you, I'm not. I mean, I like some of them. They're not all like Clay, you know?
Yeah, but you're still working here.
Why wouldn't I be? I enjoy what I do.
Yeah, but sometimes you have to take a stand, David.
Mary, that's not fair. Look, you've got this great passion, journalism. What if I disagree with something with Harry? I see they're still writing about the football team, about Clay's potential. I'm sure you found that offensive.
It's not the same thing.
Yes, it is. Football is a passion for me. I like being a part of it any way I can. Now I'm just supposed to drop everything to make some moral point that in the long run isn't going to mean anything to anybody.
It would mean something to me.
So why don't I just drop out of school or leave the entire state? Would that be far enough from Clay for you?
Clay Roberts raped Holly.
Yeah, well, I wonder...
What is that supposed to mean?
We were both there that night. We saw how drunk Holly was getting.
So what?
So only Holly and Clay know what happened in that room that night. Not me. Certainly not you. Mary.
Chocolate bar named after me, Butterfingers. What's up, man?
Thanks for meeting me. I got something you might be interested in, but it's private.
See you, private.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, what's up?
You go to the ball, I'm the only one you talk to. Agreed?
Yeah, you heard I talked to Stewart.
We were supposed to have a deal.
It was not the man, all right? We're still cool.
It's pretty ingenious, actually, the way she's done it. By writing in a hypothesis and making it an op-ed piece, she doesn't have to actually say it. But with everyone talking the way they are, and this, everyone's gonna think you raped Holly Sherman, and the university's letting you get away with it.
Going to a study group over at Grayston Hall. It's not even 5 minutes from here. You know, I thought slashing my tires was just a warning or something. How was I supposed to know they were setting me up?
You say they all wore masks?
Yeah, but that doesn't mean I don't know who they were.
Clay Roberts and his football class.
Yeah. They're upset with me because I've been investigating a rape on campus.
Which you say Clay Roberts allegedly committed.
Gardner. Yeah? Yeah, okay. Thanks. Clay Roberts was at a party tonight with about 30 of his frat brothers.
Well, that doesn't mean he was there the whole night. I mean, they're frat brothers, for God's sake. They probably threw another party just to give each other alibis.
Look, Miss Stewartson, I wish I could do more for you, but... look, if you want to file a complaint, you're going to have to go through the Dean of Student Affairs.
They won't do anything.
I'm sorry.
Me too.
All right, Mary, I think that about covers it. I can just get you to sign about there, please.
You don't believe me, do you?
Oh, I believe something happened out there. And I can see that you were badly frightened, Mary. I believe that.
But?
Well, let's just say we've had incidents like this before. Young men out for some fun, thinking that they're just teasing and joking around. They never stop to think how their actions might affect someone.
You think it was just a couple guys out to tease me?
Well, why don't we let the dean read this? And he will let you know whatever action is to be taken.
Uh-huh. And how long will it take the dean to come to this decision?
No more than 7 to 10 days, and he'll be calling you in then.
Right. 7 to 10 days. Thanks anyway.
Mary, if you need to walk around campus at night, you do know that there are security guards who look accompany you wherever you need to go. The university established that service years ago.
You wouldn't think they'd have to, Cornwall being such a safe campus. Hey, heard there was another frat party last night. Were you there?
Yeah.
What about Clay Roberts?
Yeah, so what?
The whole night?
Mary, I'm not his babysitter. You got a point to this?
Are you saying you don't know that I was attacked last night? Can I ask you a question? Because there's something that really confuses me. I mean, you know Clay raped your date the other night. I know you do. And yet you're still friends with him. Explain that to me. God, what does it take to piss you off?
That's $2.
Following me.
Who?
Them, Clay. Holly, how many pills have you taken tonight?
Two. Maybe. I tried to sleep. I can't anymore. See, I told you I wasn't lying. They put that under the door. See, there's another one, but I can't find it.
Holly, we should go to the police. There's a detective there named Rubin.
No.
She can help.
No.
Look, Holly, Clay hurt you. And now they're threatening me.
I can't.
What are you looking at?
God, I can't take this anymore.
Holly, how about I take you back to the dorm, okay? I'll sit with you till you fall asleep, all right? You can't run it.
Why not?
I just left Holly at the dorm. She's falling apart. That article will just make it worse.
Even though this is better than good? Even though I think this may stand a chance of getting picked up nationally?
I'm sorry, but I have to think about Holly. Someone does.
Does this have anything to do with you getting roughed up last night?
If it did, I'd say run the article. The hell with Clay Roberts. But my roommate got raped. And she is this close to going over the edge. I won't do anything that might make her go all the way.
You have to do what you think's best. I have to admit, I was getting some not so subtle hints to, how should I say this, curb one of my reporters' enthusiasm. Seemed someone was sticking their nose in where it didn't belong.
Thanks. You know, you never tell me what to do. I mean, you give me hints, maybe steer me in a certain direction, but you never tell me what to write. I want to pull a story, and you don't even object.
I have faith in you.
Yeah, I guess you do. Thanks.
Mary! Man, I just heard what happened.
They were just trying to scare me. It did scare me.
Are you all right? I'm so sorry. I feel like such a jerk.
No, I'm the one that should be apologizing.
For what?
Well, sometimes for me. I mean, everything's black and white. And I get so caught up, I forget that other people have their own feelings, their own opinions. And they're just as important as mine. Sorry.
Don't worry about it.
Look, I'm going home for a couple days to visit my parents. When I get back, we'll talk some more, okay?
Definitely.
Wow.
What's up, Clay?
Looks like you got a decision to make, my friend. You part of the solution, you part of the problem.
Huh?
I thought that was your beast I heard chugging up the driveway.
Yeah, it needs a tune-up.
How you doing?
Hey, sweetie.
Okay. Oh, I didn't even hear you come in.
Give me the keys.
Thanks, Dad.
So, you... How are you doing? You okay?
Yeah. It wasn't that bad.
Hey, wait a minute. You were attacked. You want to tell me it wasn't that bad?
It was just some kids pushing me around, trying to scare me off the story.
Did it work?
I've told the story. But not because of them. Because it could have hurt Holly.
Come on. You hungry?
Mm-hmm. I don't know. I can't help thinking that maybe I failed somehow.
Failed Holly or failed yourself?
What's the difference?
You want me to take that down? You still miss Caroline a lot, don't you? You gotta stop blaming yourself, sweetheart. It wasn't your fault. There was nothing you could have done. You gotta know that.
Yeah. I'm gonna go outside and help Dad. Doc, can you save her?
You hand me the 7/8 over there. Cornwall isn't the only college in the state, you know.
It's the only one I got a scholarship to.
Well, your mom and I were talking about that. And we think you should find another school, a safer one. We have some money put away for an emergency like this.
That's for your retirement. Dad, I love you both for offering, but I can't quit now. I mean, apart from loving my classes, how could I hold my head up if I left? You told me to make you proud of me, Daddy. You know I have to stay and do that.
So is it really hard at the university?
Sometimes. But if you put in a little effort and study a few evenings a week instead of hitting the student union every night, you usually do all right.
There are a lot of cute guys there, huh?
Since when are you interested in guys?
I'm not. Can I have a salad? I'm just asking, that's all.
Yeah, right.
So, I bet you could be a cheerleader if you wanted.
Why would I want to be a cheerleader?
Because then you can hang out with all the football players. The Falcons, they're supposed to be going to the Cotton Bowl this year. Maybe even the Sugar Bowl. If you become a cheerleader, then maybe you can be on TV, just like that.
I don't want to be on TV. I don't want to be a cheerleader, and I certainly don't want to hang out with any Cro-Magnons who think it's a sport to throw pigskin and butt heads.
Pigskin? They make footballs out of pigs?
I'm going back to school tomorrow.
Uh-huh. What are you gonna do?
I don't know yet. But sitting at dinner, looking at Bobby, I just kept thinking, what if she grows up and goes to Cornwall? If nothing's changed, what then?
You've always followed your heart and your conscience. You gotta promise me one thing. If you need anything, anything at all, whether it's just someone to talk to or a shoulder to cry on, I want you to call me immediately. Okay?
I will. Thanks, Mom.
It's all your father's fault, you know. You got your stubbornness from him. From me, you got your nose.
I was only gone overnight.
Yeah, but I still missed you.
Yeah, I missed you too. Hey, David, do you remember me telling you about Caroline?
Yeah, she was the girl you used to write neighborhood newsletters with.
That's her. Caroline Harrington. She had the real talent.
She's not alive anymore, is she?
No, how'd you know that?
It's just this, look you get in your eyes when you talk about her.
She was killed in a car accident. I was driving. This car came out of nowhere. And when I woke up, I was laying on the ground. I still remember how bright the stars were. When I turned my head, there was Caroline. She was dead.
My God, that must have been horrible for you.
Was. I mean, Caroline, we practically grew up together. I mean, like sisters. I knew her ever since I was 8. She died. I thought I would die too. My mother thinks I'm still blaming myself for the accident.
Are you?
It wasn't my fault. I mean, I know that logically. But inside, I keep wondering, you know, if I had just driven down a different street or waited 5 more seconds before starting the car. I mean, irrational thoughts, but they're always there.
Yeah, it's like, survivor's guilt.
Yeah. I think that's what I'm getting at. I mean, everything with Holly, it's bringing out those same emotions. You know, like, if I didn't agree to go to the party, would Holly have gone? If I just stayed an hour longer, or if I had insisted she'd leave with us.
Mary, what happened with Holly is not your fault.
No, I know that. But still, I mean, I keep searching for something to make it right. There has to be something. Not just for Holly.
What's your choice, Mac? We're a man short.
Oh, I can't. I got loads of work I gotta do.
Come on, man. It'll be a wuss.
What is that, a dare?
Take it any way you want, man.
All right, Augie. All right. Just for you, though. And remember, I'm playing with a bum leg.
Yeah, great. Check it up top.
Here are those copies of the statistics you wanted. I hope they'll help.
So Detective Brubaker was right about the number of assaults on campus.
Cornwall's not the worst in the country for this kind of thing, but it's not the best either. It's the university system. If they don't count cases that result in outside charges, they keep their statistics down.
But according to this, hardly any cases result in charges being filed.
Well, maybe they would if the school allowed the police to get involved in the investigations.
This is all just so wrong.
I'm sorry about your roommate.
Yeah, me too. Thanks for everything.
Mary, wait. I think what you're doing is important, not just because it's right, but because you care. Those 21 women who were raped on campus last year. I was one of them.
I see you've changed your angle. You know, if I print this, you're gonna make a lot of people very angry.
Run it.
Do you have any idea what you have done? What kind of adverse publicity you could bring down on this university? I mean, what were you thinking?
There were 21 girls reportedly raped on this campus last year.
Yes, and you implied we covered that up.
That's not true. I wrote that the university held hearings in 15 of those cases. But because there was no disciplinary action, didn't include the number in their safety statistics.
Because there was no need. It was determined those cases were unfounded.
But this university's not equipped to make that decision. Don't you see, the system you've set up at Cornwall to deal with serious crime simply isn't working? I mean, I was attacked on this campus, and it takes me over a week to get in to see you.
Now, hold on here. I'm Dean of Student Affairs. I'm not campus police. These things don't always reach my desk in a timely fashion.
Yeah, but suddenly you have a concern, and I'm rushed in here immediately.
So what, you think dragging Cornwall's name through the mud is going to change things, is that it?
Mr. Dixon, I love this school. And I'm sorry, I just don't see what's wrong with trying to fix it.
Well,
they go to the bowl game, he's promised me an exclusive. And I thought maybe I could do a two-parter. I mean, I'll cover the game and everything. And then do an in-depth on Clay Roberts. Following through his junior high career to
Mary. Hey, hi. I've been looking all over for you. Do you have a minute?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah? Mm-hmm.
I like what you wrote.
Thanks.
You okay? I mean, after what happened the other night?
Yeah, they were just a bunch of jerks. Seriously, Holly, I'm fine.
Keep missing each other back at the dorm.
Yeah, I know. I've been pretty crazy the last few days. I've been worried about you, though.
I know. I look better, though, now, don't I?
Yeah, you do.
I finished those sleeping pills the doctor gave me. You probably already know that. I was gonna go by and get some more, but then I just figured I hate myself, you know? I'm seeing the school shrink.
I know. How's it going?
It's good. I mean, it's okay. It's been telling me that I gotta take care of myself. Take care of me first. So that's what I'm gonna do. Go to school, sleep, eat.
Holly.
No, it's okay. I just wanna blend into the background, you know? Maybe then people forget and go back to being who I was.
Don't you see that's what's so wrong? A guy does something like that and we say to him, forget him. Let him go on with his life. What does that say to him? To Clay? He says that he can get away with it. Don't you see? We have to stop him before he goes on to the next girl.
I'm just trying to hang on here, Mary. That's all.
For you, Dean.
Harry Stewartson, you read her article in the Clarion?
Yeah. Seems to me that article was about the adjudication system. It had nothing to do with any of my guys.
Of course, nothing to stop her from writing another one. Maybe this time naming some names.
She does, she'll get her ass sued off.
You still think your boy's telling the truth, huh?
Absolutely.
Well, that is good, because I'll tell you what. I don't care if that boy is the best hope we've got. Championship or no championship. I've got to do what's right for the whole school.
Sorry about your car.
Total loss?
The engine is. The electrics were trashed. Everywhere gas goes, the water went. It's in the exhaust, too, which means it was running, which means it's in the cylinders.
Do you have insurance?
Yeah. And I filed a police report on campus and off. How many
copies? Oh, about the...
This table's taken.
I was sitting here before.
Yeah, well, now it's taken. Sorry.
What's going on?
Nothing. Nothing's going on.
Yeah, you heard her. Table's taken, that's all.
What is wrong with you?
Don't. Just... don't bother.
So, Mary, how's your car running?
How's your GPA? You know, I heard you flunked Mr. Caldwell's art history exam. I guess someone studied the wrong questions, huh?
Whatever.
Here we go. You know, Billy, I really liked you in high school. I mean, you were a nice guy.
Sure.
What happened to you?
Look, it took a football scholarship for me to get into this school. You know, but that was okay because I thought I was good. You know, and I was good for a high school receiver, but here, I'm just one of a dozen. You know, all just as good, all ready to step in and take over my spot when I slip up. You don't get it, do you? I mean, we're going to a bowl game. That means national TV coverage, NFL scouts, a chance at a real future. Not selling used cars like my brother back home.
So maybe getting on TV gives you the right to treat Holly like crap?
No, it doesn't, and I'm sorry about that. Damn it, I like Holly. But I gotta be part of the team, Mary. Look, it's my only chance. I gotta be part of the team.
I stuck my nose in again where it didn't belong. You only did what you thought was right. Still friends? We'll always be friends. I came out here to be sure. I really did love it all, you know? Football games, the crowds, the noise. It's like one big party. I'm dropping out of school. But you can't. I'm not like you, Mary. Only had so much fight in me. It's gone.
It's not fair. Clay Roberts should be the one leaving.
It may not be fair. That's the way it's gonna be.
Hey, man. The hell is that for?
Saw you talking to Stewartson.
Yeah, well, so I talked to her. Big deal.
You know, you're right. You are just one of a dozen. You better get used to selling used cars with your brother.
You know, screw you, man.
Come here, Billy. Okay? You don't want a piece of me, all right?
You raped her, didn't you, Clay? Didn't you?
So this is over? Some
football groupie?
Why don't you just answer the question?
No, okay? I wanted to. She wanted to. But I didn't have sex with her. I wouldn't do that to you, man. I promise. Okay?
I write a negative piece about the school, and suddenly I get a letter from administration saying my funding's being put on hold.
Can they do that?
I don't know, but they did. I worked so hard to win that scholarship.
Well, can you file a grievance with the dean's office?
I already thought about that. They just take forever, and they probably wouldn't do anything anyways.
Well, it's ridiculous. I mean, there's got to be some kind of appeals process, right? I don't know.
I'm starting to feel just like Holly. Maybe I should just give up and go home.
Hey, don't say that, all right? Don't ever say that.
You're right. I can't leave now. At least not without a fight. Nobody's touched it since that night.
You don't know that.
Okay, I don't, but why would it still be there otherwise?
All right, so the two of you saw her wearing this exact dress that night?
Yes.
There may not be any evidence on it at all.
There might be. I mean, Holly said when Clay raped her, she was still wearing the dress. Please say it's worth a chance to run the tests.
It's worth a chance to run the tests.
I'll tell you one thing, you certainly have the right conditions for a game today. I mean, the weather is optimum, isn't it?
Hey, Clay!
I'll tell you what, I'll catch up to you. Mm-hmm.
How you doing, Mr. Dixon?
I was hoping I'd get a chance to talk to you before you had to go suit up.
Yes, sir.
Hey, we're gonna win this game today.
Absolutely. I mean, the Saints have a tough offense, but I think we're ready for them.
That is good. I cannot tell you, well, I don't mean to, what an undefeated season can do for this school.
No, sir, it can do a lot for all of us.
Yeah, I just hate for anything to come along and throw a wrench in the works, you know?
I'm not sure I know what you're getting at, sir.
Well, I'm hearing a lot of rumors about, and I want to get them out of my head so I can go take my seat and enjoy this game.
Mr. Dixon, I'll swear on a stack of Bibles if that's what you want. But I did not have sex with that girl. Not in any way, shape, or form.
All right. Good game.
Thanks.
David?
He's probably with Little Miss Mary. Who cares? He's finished around here anyway. Hey, Connors.
Yeah.
You're gonna back me up out there, right?
Yeah, sure, man. I always do.
taking so long. Either it's there or it isn't.
All right, you said that Clay Roberts maintains absolutely no sexual intercourse took place?
Yes.
Well, then he's going to have a hard time explaining what we found on that dress in there.
There's evidence?
Oh, enough for a DNA match.
That's great. Now what?
Well, we still got a couple of problems. First of all, I have to prove that sample belongs to Roberts. For that, I have to get a warrant, bring him in, and take some blood samples. But we need Holly. She has to come in and sign a formal complaint. Do you think we can get her to do that?
I don't know, but I'll try.
Because without her, we got nothing.
I knew it. I knew you would. Thanks. Holly's gonna file charges.
Good work. We got the warrant. Got one of my officers meeting me at the stadium with it. Well, you want to live to the big game?
Let's go.
5:29 to go, and it has been a great one. Two undefeated teams really going after each other. Saints by three, 24-21. This was billed as a Heisman Trophy shootout, and it's been all of that and much, much more. First and 10, Dolphins at their own 45, Saints in their standard 4-3 formation, showing blitz.
Set, hut, hut, hut.
Roberts back to pass, he's forced out of the pocket. Oh, kick and sacked. Wrong for a 10-yard loss. That's a tough break for the Falcons.
Let's go.
Let's see what the Falcons come up with next as time continues to tick away. A field goal ties it, but may not get them into a bowl game.
Goodman on three. Pass 54, Goodman on three. Ready?
Second down and 20. The Falcons are going to have to go to the air if they hope to win this game.
125, 84! 129!
Back to pass. He fires to Connor, who makes a leaping catch at the 47. And the Falcons are beginning to roll.
Number 31 takes the handoff. Fumble. Falcons recover their own fumble on the 45-yard line. Third down and 20 on the Cornwall 45.
Not now, Mr. Stewartson. If you need to talk to me, I suggest you make an appointment with my office.
There's a detective here to see you, sir. I didn't think you'd want to talk to her here in front of all your guests.
Come on. 25 seconds left. Last chance for Cornwall as the clock continues to run. Third down. The Saints once again showing blitz.
Blue 16! Blue 16! Blue, blue, blue. Come on.
Roberts signals for timeout with 13 seconds left in the game.
What are you doing? They're in cover zero. They're in cover zero.
All right, guys. We only got time for one more play. What do you like?
Let's go, Billy.
All right, let's go with pass 68K. Oh, we can do it!
Come on!
Now, we'll be taking Clay Roberts in for questioning on the rape of Holly Sherman. You do understand that, don't you, Dean?
Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
Yes. Yes, of course.
Right, this is it. This is everything. Now give me some time. 68K on three. 68K on three. Ready?
All right. This is the season as the Falcons come to the line of scrimmage. Just 13 seconds remaining. Conclusion to a great season as the Saints beat the Falcons 24-21.
It's okay, man.
They've reinstated my funding. I don't have to leave.
That's great.
Yeah, and with Clay's indictment, the Dean of Student Affairs is recommending that all students be allowed legal representation in any future cases. And look, the center is setting up a yearly awareness campaign as part of orientation week. It's not much, but it's a start.
It's a great start.
Yeah, it is.
Thank you. Lakeview, over.
Oh, man, there's no fear.
Hey, not shut that thing.
Fear. Come on, it's taking so long.
I'm almost there.
Two, over.
Residents belonging to Professor Caldwell have been unable to verify occupancy, over.
Man, will you look at this? I thought art history test was supposed to be easy.
Copy. Let's go.
Done.
Probably not. Two up.
Oh, boys, we got company.
Oh, man, I'm out of here.
Let's go. Let's go. Go.
She better not be getting in any of my CDs.
Oh. Okay, kiddo. It's an emergency.
Mom, you can't afford this.
Shh. Thanks.
Make us proud, Mary Catherine.
I will, Dad. Bye, Mom.
Hey, you guys drive carefully.
Always.
Foot.
Sorry about that.
Don't worry about it. Hey, you're in my economics class.
Yeah, I know. You were out the second week with strep, right?
You noticed. Yeah, what's my name? David McPherson.
Mary Stewartson.
Hey, you know, some of these guys call me Mac, but I like David.
David.
Uh-huh. Actually, I'm part of the team. I take care of the equipment. Woo!
Hey,
Stewartson. Marvelous place.
Jesse, what's going on?
You're a reporter. You figure it out.
You know, not everything has to be a competition. Sorry, I was late. My poli-sci test went over.
Yeah. Listen, Mary, I have an assignment for you if you want it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, there was a break-in last night at Professor Caldwell's house while he was at the pep rally.
Convenient. Anything taken?
Apparently not.
Any suspects?
Three. Running away from the house. Too dark to see any faces.
And nothing was taken. Doesn't sound like much.
No, probably not, but...
This is me leaving. Have you ever had anything like this happen before?
A couple of years ago, I was TP'd on Halloween, but then the whole block was.
And you're sure nothing was stolen? No jewelry, money, electronics, anything like that?
Nope.
Okay. Thanks for your time, Professor.
Sure thing.
Professor, I was just thinking, the midterms are coming up. I mean, you don't by any chance keep your test sheets here at home, do you?
Well, they're on the computer, but they need my password to get in. Perfect.
Birth dates, social security numbers, mother's maiden name. They're all the most common passwords.
Well, you were right. Somebody logged on last night.
They took the test questions?
Well, someone was definitely in that file. Oh, I guess it was time to change that test anyway, huh?
You think they were students?
Yeah, they were students.
How can you be so sure? You know who did it, don't you?
Well, I didn't see any faces, if that's what you mean.
Well, you have an idea. I mean, you must if you say they were students.
I have an idea. Look, let me put it to you this way. I used to play football, and I know the difference between getting shoved by some punk and taking a hit from an all-conference blocking back.
Are you saying they were football players that broke into Professor Caldwell's house?
I'm saying they were big and fast and strong, and I took a hit.
Thanks for your time.
I called a reverse, remember?
Yeah, I remember.
And where the hell were you?
Where was I?
Yeah.
Right here!
Knock it off!
You
knock
see?
That off, you guys!
Right here!
Knock that off! Boswell!
Sorry, Coach. Guess I missed him.
You do it again, you're not starting on Saturday. You hear me? Now let's play football!
All right. Atkins formation, pass 50K on one. Ready?
Excuse me.
All right, let's go!
Oh, this is a close practice, sweetheart.
Get off the ball!
Coach Jefferson, Mary Stewartson, from the Clarion. I was wondering if I could interview a couple of your players.
Well, why don't you talk to me first, then we'll see.
Well, I know you guys are going to be going to a bowl game if everything works out.
Damn straight.
Roberts, what are you doing? He was wide open there!
Well, I was just wondering... I mean, what would happen if one of your players was involved in something he shouldn't have been? Would he be taken out of the lineup? Because I've heard stories where athletes commit crimes and, like, let's say, possibly breaking into a professor's house, maybe stealing test questions and never being disciplined for it. Because the game's the thing, right?
Yeah, the game is the thing, miss. But let me tell you something. I would never condone any of my players committing a criminal act. Now, you asked if he'd be out of the lineup. Not only would he be out of the lineup, he'd be out in that parking lot so fast to make his eyes spin. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Carter! Hello! Where's your man? Come on, people! Think! Think!
Yes. I'm Mary Stewartson from the Clarion. I'm working on a story about the break-in and robbery at Professor Caldwell's house last night.
Robbery? I was under the impression nothing was stolen.
Well, it looks like Professor Caldwell's computer files were broken into. And it's possible one of his tests was taken. It's also possible members of the football team were involved.
Who told you that?
A source, actually. I would like to know what would happen if members of the football team were implicated in the robbery.
Standard operating procedures for the review and disciplinary process, adjudicating student conduct. You're welcome to look through them if you like, Miss Stewartson.
You enjoyed yourself?
Yeah. That was fun, thanks.
My pleasure. Ah, lovely evening for a walk. So you really think it was someone on the team that broke into Caldwell?
Possibility. Any ideas?
Oh, God, I don't know, you know. I mean, I like being a part of the team in some ways, but I don't really know any of the guys that well. You're using me as a source, aren't you?
Well, maybe just a little. I'm just trying to find my way into the story. I don't know, maybe it was just a couple kids fooling around, stealing test questions, but what if it was someone on the team? With the Falcons coming up in a bowl game, it could make for an interesting mix.
If it was one of the Falcons. So you always wanted to be a writer?
Yeah, when I was 8, I had this friend, Caroline, and we used to write these newsletters, give them to our neighbors.
Uh-huh. How long did you do that for?
Until Caroline wrote about Mrs. White in the corner house and her good-looking brother that would come over every night when Mr. White was at work.
And I guess that Mrs. White never had a brother, huh?
Mm-hmm. Hey, you guys.
There's Lily.
It wasn't Billy. It was Clay. Clay Roberts. He raped me. I was afraid. I mean, I like Clay Roberts, but I didn't want to sleep with him. I thought that we're just gonna go up and talk, you know? When we got in the room, he told me to take off my dress. He was kidding. He started touching me. I tried to fight. I swear to God, I did. But he was so strong. He put my hands up and I tried to scream. He put his hand over my mouth. And I couldn't breathe. He was so heavy.
To get you to a hospital.
No, I'm not going to a hospital.
You have to let a doctor look at you. Like, what if he gave you something? You know you have to let a doctor see you. You know you do.
I just want to go to sleep for a while. I just want to close my eyes. Then we'll go, okay?
This way.
Thank you.
This is Dr. Taylor.
I want you to take these only if you have trouble sleeping. Holly, the university in this center has set up some excellent resources to handle situations like these. Counseling, support groups. I'm going to send your test results to Mr. Dixon, the Dean of Student Affairs. I think it's a good idea if you see him as soon as possible. His office can handle everything for you. Now, I made an appointment for you to come back and see me next week. But if you need me for anything, even if it's just to talk, you call me here at the center, okay?
Thanks.
Well, I guess it's time to go to the cops.
I'm not going to the cops.
Why not?
You are Dr. Taylor. They've got plenty of resources here on campus that can help.
Well, yeah, but...
I'm not going to the cops.
I'm sorry, but he's going to get away with it, Holly.
Not if I go to the Dean of Student Affairs. We'll go on his record. He'll be punished.
By maybe kicking him out of school or suspending him for a semester. I mean, what if they just put him on probation? He should be in jail.
Maybe.
What do you mean, maybe?
It's just everything seems so different in the light of day, you know? And you saw me, I was pretty wasted, and so was Clay.
That doesn't give him the right to rape you. Holly, you said no. That should have been enough.
I know, okay, but what if I had done something different? What if I hadn't gone upstairs, or if I'd said something else, or what if he didn't hear me right? Or maybe he got the wrong idea from the way I was acting.
Tell me you're not saying you think this was your fault.
I don't think it was my fault.
That's the way she wants it, Mom. I don't know what else I can do.
She won't go to the police. You can't force her.
No, it's just... This guy should be in jail.
Honey?
There isn't any possibility that he might try anything else, is there? I mean, you were sharing a room with Holly.
No, he'd have to be crazy to try something, especially with the hearing coming up tomorrow.
Are you going to be there with her?
I'm not allowed in the actual hearing. No one is. Holly has to go in alone. I'll be waiting for her outside.
Mary?
Mom, I have to go. Holly's awake.
Okay, well, please tell her I'm thinking about her.
I will. Love you both.
That's going to wrap it up for now, Miss Sherman. Anything you would like to add?
No, I don't think so. Right. So, what's going to happen now?
Well, now, of course, need to listen to Mr. Roberts' version of the event and just determine what action may be necessary and appropriate. Okay. You're going to be notified just as soon as there is a decision.
Thank you.
You know, I do want to assure you, this university and this office in particular would never countenance the type of behavior you've just spoken of. We take these matters very, very seriously. I hope you can take advantage of some of our counseling services.
Thank you.
All right.
You okay?
Hey, Mr. Dixon, how are you?
Counsel, could you and your client join me inside my office?
Excuse me a second.
You specifically told Holly she had to come in alone.
It's fine.
How come he gets to have a lawyer present?
Because that is how this university's adjudication system works.
That is not fair.
The accused has a right to counsel if and when he chooses. Could you excuse us, please?
How is she?
Not so good. She's sort of pretending it never happened.
Look, if there's anything I can do, please.
I don't think so, but thanks for asking.
Is she gonna go to the police?
No. I keep asking her, but she's determined to see it through the university system. Clay Roberts gets to bring in an attorney, but Holly has to go in alone. Does that sound fair?
You know, Holly's really lucky to have a friend like you.
Difficult at best, and the university has the responsibility to act in what it deems to be the best interest of all concerned. In this case, since there is no physical evidence that intercourse took place, no physical evidence, but what about the test you took at the center, Holly? What about... Holly.
You must hate me.
No, of course not.
You know, May, I know that if I hadn't taken that shower cleaned up the way I did, there would have been some evidence, something.
Holly, I probably would have done the same thing if I was in your situation.
I don't know how I could have been so stupid.
You know, I think it's time we go talk to the real cops.
All right, you know what? It's gonna be the same old thing, my word against Clay Roberts. I don't want to think about it anymore. I just want to forget it. It's over.
Oh! You got the touch of problem.
Help you?
Yes. I need to talk to someone about reporting a rape.
Let me see who's available.
Detective Brubaker, you wanted to talk to me about a rape?
Yes. It was my roommate at the university.
Morning. So this party, you were there?
Yes, but I left with a friend before it happened.
Were there any witnesses to the crime?
Holly said it was just Clay and her in the room.
Did she scream or call for help? Is there a chance maybe somebody heard her struggling?
I don't know. I mean, the music was really loud. Besides, she said Clay had his hand over her mouth.
And where's your roommate now?
Probably still in bed. The doctor gave her these sleeping pills.
Okay, Mary, here's the problem the way I see it. You want to report a rape. Only the victim won't come in and give a formal statement. There's no physical evidence, and the alleged perpetrator who claims no sexual act took place has already been found innocent under the university system.
But he's walking around campus like he didn't do anything. I should have insisted she come here first. I knew she shouldn't have gone through the university.
Let me show you something. That's 21 sexual assaults at Cornwall last year.
But our campus is listed as one of the safest in the country.
Mm-hmm. That's because only two of those cases resulted in charges.
Why?
Well, it was hard enough for most of those women to report their assaults. Now, unfortunately, if you wait too long, the evidence we need to charge a suspect simply isn't there anymore.
Hey, Mary. Long time no see.
Hey.
What's going on?
Hey, Mac. How you doing?
What's up, Billy?
Billy and I went to Kennedy High together.
Oh, you did?
Mm-hmm. Actually, that's how we met. I told him my roommate went to his high school, and we just started talking. So took it from there.
Mm-hmm.
So, Mac, you going to the Alpha Tau party Saturday night?
I don't know, man. It's not my...
Come on, man. It'll be a blast.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You ever been to a frat party?
Come on. It'll be fun.
Come on.
Come on. All right. Sure, why not?
Good.
Good.
Hey, why don't you guys sit down and grab a drink?
Yeah.
Not much here, is there?
That's all I've got so far. Someone broke into Caldwell's house, logged on his computer, and probably took the test questions. Yeah, I know the article's boring. But the guard implied that the guys were big enough to be football players. Maybe I can question some of the Falcons at the Alpha Tau party on Saturday.
Good luck. You know they're off limits this close to a game.
Yeah, I guess I pressed the coach too hard.
Well, burning the source. It happens.
Not to me.
Shake a leg, you know what I mean?
You having fun?
Yeah, you know, it's fun.
Yeah, well, you know, it is what it is, right?
Hey, you know, we don't have to hang out here if you don't want to. Seriously, come on, let's get out of here. We'll go somewhere where we can actually hear each other.
Are you sure?
I'm positive.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, I had a great time.
what's going on. Something happened at the party tonight?